everyone, it's Justin again. In the last couple of lessons, we talked about translations and reflections on the graph of 1 over x. Now, let's take a look at one more type of transformation, dilations. By the end of this lesson, you should be able to identify dilations of reciprocal functions in graphs and equations. First, we'll review the rules of dilations using functions we know. We'll use that knowledge to explore the effects of dilations on reciprocal functions, and then we'll practice with a couple of examples. Dilating can also be called stretching and compressing, or scaling. We learned about stretching and compressing graphs of functions a few units back. Because stretching and compressing can look very similar on some graphs, we're going to be sticking with the term dilating. We can dilate a function by multiplying a constant into the equation. Keep in mind that the k is only there to show where the number would go to make the dilation vertical or horizontal. Examples of vertical dilation might be 5 times f of x or 2/3 times f of x. In vertical dilation, the number is multiplied outside of the function. And in horizontal dilation, the number is multiplied inside of the function. For example, f of 3x or f of 1/2 x. Let's go back to a function that we've seen before, the square root of x, to remind ourselves what these dilations look like before trying them out on 1 over x. Can you predict what the graph of 2 times the square root of x will look like? The point 1, 1 moves up to 1, 2, because after taking the square root, we then multiply the output by 2. So this vertical dilation by 2 takes each point on the function and brings it twice as high. Similarly, a vertical dilation by 1/2 brings the graph down to half its original height. The point 4, 2, for example, moves down to 4, 1 because we're taking each number that comes out of the square root and cutting it in half. A horizontal dilation, in the case of the square root of x, would happen on the inside of the root. Here we have the graph of the square root of 2x. At first glance, it looks pretty similar to when we had the vertical dilation of 2 times the square root of x, but the points are not twice as high, so this isn't quite the same graph. Actually, what's happening this time is that the points are half as far away from the y-axis. On the original graph, the square root of 4 is 2, so we have the point 4, 2. But to get to the same y value as you get from the square root of x, you would need to put a number half as big into the square root of 2x. So instead of the point 4, 2, we have the point 2, 2. That's what makes this a horizontal dilation. Lastly, it should also be noted what happens if we dilate by a negative number. Any guesses what it will look like if we perform a vertical dilation on the square root of x by a factor of negative 1? Pick an x value or 2 and see what the corresponding y values would be to help you graph negative 1 times the square root of x. Pause the video and try it now. Ready for the big reveal? It'll be the same as a reflection across the x-axis. Multiplying by negative 1 is the same as putting a negative in front of the function, which is what we do for a reflection. Any dilation by negative 1 is the same as a reflection. For this lesson, though, to avoid possible mix-ups with reflections, we're going to only work with dilations by positive numbers. As we move on to dilating the graph of 1 over x, keep in mind how the effects are different when we multiply on the outside of a function versus multiplying on the inside. Now, what do dilations look like on the function 1 over x? To explore this, let's try out vertical and horizontal dilations by numbers greater than 1 and less than 1. We'll see what connections we can make, and then we'll move on to some examples afterwards. Let's just start with a vertical dilation of 2. Remember what it looked like when we multiplied the square root function by 2. So can you make a guess as to what the function 2 times 1 over x or 2 over x will look like? Let's look at what will happen to some points to inform us of what will happen to the whole graph. There are a couple of points on the graph of 1 over x that are best to watch for dilations. These points are 1, 1 and negative 1, negative 1. 1 is the most straightforward number when it comes to multiplication. If we're doing a vertical dilation by a factor of 2, then the point with a y value of 1 will now have a y value of 2. Likewise, negative 1 goes down to negative 2. If we're taking all outputs of 1 over x and multiplying them by 2, then each point will go twice as high, or twice as low. The graph will look like this. At first glance, since the graphs seem to be so close together, it might not look like every point doubled in height. But by tracing the heights of a few other points, we can see that it really is a vertical dilation by 2. Each point is twice as high or twice as low as the corresponding point in the original graph. And just like with reflections, notice that this has not changed the vertical or horizontal asymptote. Now, what do you think a vertical dilation by 1/2 will look like in the equation and in the graph? Let's start with the equation. The new function, representing a vertical dilation by 1/2, will be 1/2 times 1 over x. We can multiply the numerators and multiply the denominators together, so that would simplify to 1 over 2x. As for the graph, let's keep an eye on 1, 1 and negative 1, negative 1 again. These points will have their y values cut in half down to 1/2 and negative 1/2. This is what the full graph looks like when dilating by 1/2 vertically. Each point on the new graph is half its height from the original graph. And once more, the asymptotes have not changed. You could take it as a fact that dilating the graph of 1 over x does not change the function's asymptotes. Now let's look at dilating 1 over x horizontally. Like we discussed with the square root example, for horizontal dilations, the multiplication happens on the inside of the function. Let's start by dilating by 2 again. Can you figure out how we would write the function that represents dilating by 2 horizontally? Well, for this dilation, the multiplying by 2 happens on the inside of the function. Since our k is 2, you could think of this as taking f of 2x. That means our new function will be 1 over 2x. If you're feeling a bit of deja vu right now, it might be because this is exactly the same function we got from our last dilation, when we dilated by a factor of 1/2 vertically. So, we actually just saw this graph. Now, knowing that a horizontal dilation by 2 is the same as a vertical dilation by 1/2, what do you think will happen when we dilate horizontally by 1/2? Let's start with the equation again. If we dilate by 1/2 horizontally by multiplying 1/2 on the inside of the function, we get 1 over 1/2 x. This is a little complicated though. We don't usually like having fractions inside of other fractions. A great way to fix this is to multiply the numerator and the denominator of the big fraction by the denominator of the little fraction inside. In this example, the little fraction is 1/2, so multiplying by 2 will cancel the 1/2 in the big fraction's denominator, and we're just left with 2 over x. Here's the graph of this function, but we've already seen this one as well. This is the same function we got when we multiplied by 2 on the outside of the function. So a horizontal dilation by 1/2 is the same as a vertical dilation by 2. Did you guess that correctly? In fact, for 1 over x, we can write any horizontal dilation as a vertical dilation, and vice versa. To see why, let's take the expression for a horizontal dilation, f of k times x, and we'll carefully keep track of what happens to 2 times x. And we put it through the function 1 over x. Since k equals 2, this represents a horizontal dilation by a factor of 2. Putting 2 times x into the function 1 over x gives us 1 over 2 times x. This can be split up into 1 over 2 times 1 over x. And this 1 over x here is none other than our original function f of x. This means we can replace 1 over x in this equation with its other name, f of x. That gives us 1 half times f of x. And that is a vertical dilation by 1 half. So a horizontal dilation by 2 is the same thing as a vertical dilation by 1 half. What makes this process so useful is that it doesn't matter that k was 2 specifically. It would work exactly the same if k were 3 or 7, and it even works the same without putting a number in for k at all. So for the function 1 over x, a horizontal dilation by any number is always the same as a vertical dilation by that number's reciprocal. To put this into words, so we can refer back to this fact later, we can say a horizontal dilation by a factor of k is the same as a vertical dilation by a factor of 1 over k, and vice versa, meaning you could swap the words horizontal and vertical, and this would still be true. A vertical dilation by k is the same as a horizontal dilation by a factor of 1 over k. Before we move on to examples, let's sum up what we just learned. Like we did with reflections, we can list the properties of dilating 1 over x, since these properties will be very useful when solving problems. Our first property can be the one we just talked about. Horizontal dilation by a factor of k is the same as a vertical dilation by a factor of 1 over k, and vice versa. Our second property, we haven't mentioned directly yet, but you may remember, is from when we tried some of the examples of vertical dilation. If f of x is dilated vertically by k, then the new graph will have the points 1, k and negative 1, negative k. The original graph has these original points. So if we multiply by k, then the outputs at 1 and negative 1 will instead be k and negative k. And lastly on our list of properties, vertical and horizontal dilation don't change the function's asymptotes. All right, now we're ready for some examples. If f of x equals 1 over x, which of the following is the same as a horizontal dilation of f of x by a factor of 1/4? A horizontal dilation by 4, a vertical dilation by 1/4, or a vertical dilation by 4. Do you see how we can figure out the right answer here? This one is pretty quick if we remember our properties of dilating 1 over x. Specifically, the first property on our list applies here. A horizontal dilation by k is the same as a vertical dilation of 1 over k. So if k is 1/4 in this example, then the horizontal dilation by 1/4 is the same as a vertical dilation by 1 over 1/4. We could turn this expression into 1 multiplied by the reciprocal of 1/4, and 1 times 4 over 1 is 4. That means the last answer option is the correct one. A horizontal dilation by a factor of 1/4 is the same as a vertical dilation by a factor of 4. We'll do one more example. The graph depicted is a dilation of the parent function 1 over x. What is the equation of g of x? First, take note of the point that's listed on the graph. Which property from our list does this bring to mind? This looks a lot like our second property. If the point 1, 3 halves is on the graph, then this must be a vertical dilation by 3 halves. A vertical dilation is done by multiplying in front of the function. So the equation of this graph must be 3 halves times 1 over x, or 3 over 2x. So that's our answer. In this lesson, we talked about dilations of the graph 1 over x. We've now talked about translations, reflections, and dilations. If you put these transformations together in different ways, you can get all sorts of interesting combinations. In our next video, we'll explore more graphs of functions like these. See you then. Hey.